My viewpoint on this is on the sort of national scope from a ministry point of view, what we have been doing during the last few years and what we are planning to do the next few years until 2017 or so. And I'm going to touch not only the publication open access in that area, but also data and also methodology, open methods and so on. So that's a kind of big thing we are thinking about in Finland right now. This is sort of illustration about the history and what we're planning for the future. So this is not sort of all encompassing only a few last years. So since 2009 or so, we have been doing quite a lot of development work in especially data-related open access topics. And there was a survey project, and then we started to do those things. The survey indicated that should be done on the national scope in Finland. And that project ended early this year, or ends now in March, actually. And then the next phase is starting right from the end of the previous one. So now we are putting together a roadmap for what we've been doing on the national scope in Finland until 2017 or so. And what we saw in the sort of last parts of the, let's say, project work and survey work we did in the, under this current now ending project was that there's a quite nice understanding what needs to be done in open access in publications. But data is much more, let's say, immature. There's a lot of open questions, but we can't wait until several years to start doing something. And then there's the third topic, we also identified the methods in the research. You could say that one aspect of those methods is open software, but that's not all. For example, we got the comment from a professor in biomedical sciences that saying that it's not a sort of just a coincidence that in that area, the scientific papers, the most mistakes are in the methodology area. So there are milligrams turned into micrograms and so on. So redoing the work becomes rather hard or difficult. And is that open approach to science? So all kinds of questions are arising, and we need to tackle those during the next few years in Finland. Also, the culture of doing research needs sort of discussion. Do we know enough about open science, what it means, what kind of licenses you need to use if you open up your data or your publication, and so on. So we also work with the researchers to find out the support they need to be able to do work as in the open environment. I'm not going to go through sort of all kinds of change factors what is happening in Finland. It's more or less same than in all countries in the world. So there are all kinds of crises happening. Then there's a sort of structural problem specific to Finland, for example, the aging population. So we have a lot of pressure for science to perform miracles so that suddenly Finland would be again competitive. We would have a very good standard of living after 10 years or 20 years in the future when there's a huge aging population to be cared of and so on. So society poses a lot of challenges to science, and then open science is one way of ensuring that the sort of innovations, inventions we find, they get recognized and people can, in various roles, can start to make benefit from those innovations. But in the end, it's sort of a rather big soup, all kinds of terms and so on. So how to make sense of what is should be done? What does it mean to have open data, open research, open science? All this needs a sort of discussion between various actors, funding agencies, universities. There are also very active sort of networks of people like citizen scientists type activities happening in Finland. They have a Facebook group, for example, called Open Science, and so on. And those are really keen on that the public sector or society should open up and take into account what they would like to do with the data, with the research publications, with the methods, and so on. So what we are doing now is to sort of establish a new sort of quite wide-ranging project, and there are a lot of sort of reasons for this to be done now, why we want to move forward with publications, data and methods rather ambitious targets in 2017. So there's a national open knowledge program in Finland which opens up the data in the public sector. There's a lot of the data that's previously hidden inside the agencies is now open in Finland, and that's one factor. What we should do with that data when it's open, is there any sort of better place than researchers, research institutes to invent something on top of the opened data? Then we are currently doing a research institute renewal, so trying to work, make research institutes and universities work better together. And there is also the opening up. We need to, research institutes have a lot of knowledge stored inside them, how to open up to research in the universities and for the benefit of the society at large. Then there's of course Horizon 2020 coming up, then this network, open science activists and so on. And then we need to lots of benefits for the society. So there's a lot of pressure to perform. So this is a rather challenging situation we have now in Finland. What should be done here? I'm not going to go through sort of in detail what is the sort of plan here. Just a few points here. So one of the aspects is sort of the visibility of science in society. So to ensure that the public at large in Finland supports those resources we put into scientific research and in universities, in research institutes. So make visible that research. That's one aspect of what we want to do and help society at large. Then there's sort of the culture change, you could say, that we want to sort of make an environment where it's sort of inspiring to open up your research and benefit from the research and opened data that's available. So that's also needs sort of soft support. It's not just the hard IT infrastructure. It's all kinds of encouragements and peer support and things like that to happen, training and so on. Then there's also lots of sort of issues that are not really settled. We have repositories for publications and so on, but they are not really maybe used to the maximum benefit for the researchers. So make things work really well with the sort of mandates we already have, and so on. There's a lots of sort of stuff to be doing during the next 4 years. And one thing we want to do is that there was a sort of survey project that what should be done, project group, they made a proposal what should Ministry of Education do. And what we want to do is based on this report to engage discussion between the actors, take these grassroots networks into play as well, and find out what we can do together to ensure that the research is as open, as inspiring as possible in Finland, and encourage also international collaboration in this area. So, as maybe I should start closing up the presentation and open up for the discussion. So, just to review the first slide there. So, what we want to do in Finland is move forward on three different areas. So, open access to publications, open access to data, and also methods research are using, so that the research is being able to verify and also be replicated for other purposes. Cross-disciplinary research is one example of this. And we want to now start discussions so that we can do together with the different actors, set the targets for 2017, that all can make their commitment, and then we can also year by year see how it proceeds. So make some indicators, evaluate each year how far we have gone, and then move forward again. So this is the process we are planning now in Finland.